URTV went along to the Dub to catch up with Neil Doak and the Ulster Ravens as they prepare for the first British and Irish Cup clash against the Bedford Blues at Ravenhill on Friday night. Well, Paul, you're looking forward to Friday night.
Yeah, definitely. It's a great opportunity to play in the new competition, the British and Irish Cup, and certainly for the likes of myself that maybe haven't played as many minutes on the team for the senior team. You know, it gives us an opportunity to get out onto the pitch and get our minutes up, and also try and put in a performance that's going to hopefully make Brian and Doki and the other coaches take a look and realise that we can step up and play at any time.
Well, Bedford are a very good quality side. They're doing well in the Championship over in England. They're in fourth place at the minute. Do you know much about them?
Yeah, we've had a look at a couple of their videos, and certainly that's one thing which we're not going to underestimate. You know, they are a very good side. They're big and physical up front, and if they're able to move the ball, their 10 likes to play a decent brand of rugby, likes to move the ball wide, and certainly we're going to have to make sure that we're on the money ourselves on Friday in defence to counteract everything that they're going to come with. But hopefully if we can get stuck in, do well at set piece and at the breakdown, then hopefully we'll have a decent amount of possession that we can really impose ourselves in the game. And as you see from the squad, we're going to have a strong team out ourselves. So certainly it's going to be a good game, and hopefully we're going to come out on the right side.
I think, yes, everybody will be surprised with just the strength of the squad and the talent of players that are actually in it. It's not just really an A team. You can nearly say that team could have gone out any time to play for Ulster themselves on the senior side.
Yeah, definitely, and I think one of the reasons behind that is, you know, a lot of guys have had injuries, like small injuries with the senior team as well, so they've maybe missed a couple of games. So there's not really anybody in the team that's played week in, week out. So from that point of view, it gives guys an opportunity just to keep their match fitness up, and also, you know, it's going to be a big few weeks for us. We've got a couple of British and Irish Cup games, we've got Glasgow at home, and then two Stade games in the European Cup. So we want to try and keep our continuity going forward as a team. We've been going well, and we want to make sure that we can maintain that the coaches can still look at us in a game environment and see how players are going to react, and that we can try new things and maybe tweak play slightly and see if they're going to work for us before some of the big games come up.
Well, Neil, the team on Friday night has got a smattering of really good quality players in it. I think a lot of people will be surprised at the quality.
Yeah, well, it gives us an opportunity. Last year we had a 5-week break, and you know, we didn't have much game time for some of the guys, so it gives us an opportunity to try the younger guys along with a few of the senior guys who can, you know, have an opportunity to start a new competition and also put a marker down for the up-and-coming Magners and European games.
Well, obviously Bedford have been going well. They have they're fourth place in the championship. They had a good win over Moseley at the weekend. Have you been doing your homework on them?
Yeah, we've had a look at two of their games. You know, they've got a big enough side. They've got a few ex-premiership guys and a couple of internationals on their side, and they look to play a little bit of rugby. You know, so hopefully if the weather holds out, you know, we obviously want to play some rugby on Friday night, and you know, hopefully it'll stand for a good game, you know, from both sides.
Well, it's very important that the Ulster public come out and support this Ravens team, both financially and as a support. We need to get the Ulster Ravenhill Roar behind them.
Yeah, look, at the end of the day, it's a new competition. We're trying to make sure that we put a quality side out. It's a Friday night at Ravenhill, and we're trying to build, you know, in this competition. We've got two games now and then a further games later on in the season, but then it leads into the Glasgow home game and the two Stade from, say, European game. So it gives us an opportunity to build on those, and as you said, try and build momentum, you know, and we're trying to make sure the season keeps going as it's going, and hopefully we pick up some more wins along the way leading into the new year.
Well, there's a lot of talk about the level of this rugby at this level and club level. There is a distinct difference between the two.
Yeah, I think, you know, we're playing a Bedford side who, you know, majority are full-time rugby players. You know, we've got guys here who, you know, are academy and senior guys. So it's definitely a step up from club rugby. And obviously the club game still has its place, and we need to make sure that, you know, the guys do get opportunities as much as they can to keep playing week in, week out, you know, because that's the way they develop. But this is definitely a slight step off from club rugby, and you know, it'll give our younger guys and some of our senior guys another opportunity.
Babe, don't be doing that, boy. Don't be teasing me.